na frankfurtskem avtomobilskem salonu sedim zraven oblikovalca te avtonomne, lahko rečem, stvari oziroma vozila prihodnosti. Hi, how are you doing?
Thank you, very well.
Excited about the new futuristic thing that you and your team has been building?
Yeah, it's an exciting future. We are going into a future where we have no steering wheel, no pedals, where we drive fully autonomous. So we don't have to worry about traffic, about traffic jams. So the time we spend in the car is our time. It's not focused on the traffic. It's not a stress time. It's a valuable time. It's a quiet time with your family, or you can work, or you can eat, but you don't have to be stressed and sit on a steering wheel. So it's a very exciting future, and I'm happy to work on that.
As a designer, do you have more problems, or do you have more things that you can think about when you don't need to build a car for a driver?
No, it's actually we have much more opportunities. In the moment where we don't have to have a steering wheel and pedals, we have a new room that we can create. So it's like your room, your personal room that you create. And you have more freedom. You don't have to worry about so many restrictions that we have today. You know, when you drive, there are so many rules about the A-post, about your vision angles and everything. So without that, we can be more creative.
But the focus is every day more and more on entertainment, infotainment, everything that comes with the car nowadays.
Yeah, it's one part of it, infotainment and entertainment. It's about the complete user experience. Whatever you want to enjoy and want you want to experience during your journey. So you can watch a movie, but you can also work if you like. You can work on your iPad, or you can sleep, or you can just relax and look out of the windows and enjoy the ride and look at the landscape.
Do the autonomous cars present an opportunity for new materials in the design? Especially nowadays when, you know, the oil is not so popular, and all the materials that come from plastic are also kind of not the BOH.
Yeah, I think there will be a huge revolution one day when we are sure we don't have crashes anymore. Because today we still need to be very solid with our cars. Even the first autonomous cars that we will see in a couple of years, they will have to be very solid. So you need steel, aluminium, and all the materials we use today. But imagine a future where all cars are connected, all vehicles are connected, and we can make sure there is no crash, because every car knows exactly where the others are. In that moment, we have total freedom with materials.
And we'll go back to wood, as it was before.
It's possible. Wood, paper, you name it, whatever material you would like to have. It's about weather protection. It's about giving you a nice feeling with warm materials, with whatever you like. But in that future, it's again more freedom, more creativity for the designers.
Is 3D printing an option?
Yeah.
You know, that everybody would design her or his new car, just print it out, put it on a chassis, and then drive away.
3D printing is absolute interesting technology today, and even more in the future. 3D printing, I think it's still in the very beginning of its chances and possibilities. Soon we will have already the first options to have personalized items in the car. Customize unique items. So you can create maybe elements in your car, especially for you. Later on, years later, we will have probably complete cars being printed, or at least very big elements of cars being printed in 3D, which will change the way we produce cars. Today we have big factories. Now in the future, it might be possible that we produce elements of the car actually where the cars are needed, so close to the city instead of away from the cities.
Do you think that the cars that are coming and are a bit futuristic are going to change the landscape the architecture of the cities as well, because you know they work together all the time.
Yeah, it's as you said, it's a collaboration almost between architecture and vehicles. You have to, you are absolutely right. You have to see it together: buildings, streets, and the vehicles in the streets. The cars are part of the of the aesthetics we are enjoying. So I think it's very important that cars are a beautiful contribution to the landscape of a city, of an urban environment. So there is, like architects, also we as car designers, we have a certain responsibility for this aesthetics that we see.
Does this futuristic element show us the direction not only the Volkswagen, but the Volkswagen Group is going as far as we can talk about design?
Design, I think, will, especially in the Volkswagen Group, you see we have the 12 brands, and we will take care that all 12 brands have their character, their individual character. So I think in the future we will make sure that there is more diversity, and that it doesn't get boring. There are so many options, so many possibilities, that I believe there will be more interesting cars and vehicles on the road than today. Design has more opportunities than we used to have. The technique gets more hidden. The technique is very complicated. We have complicated technology and computers and sensors all over the car, but it's hidden. So what you see, what you feel, what you hear is getting more and more important. And we will make sure that they are very individual and fantastic experiences with the cars, in the cars.
And the last question, how much are you as a designer concerned about the infrastructure, about the roads, in what conditions they are, how bright they are, you know, those things. How, for instance, how fast can you drive, you know? On Autobahn you can drive 300. In most of the other world, you can drive 130, 100.
Yeah, that's...
You think about it?
Yeah, yes. We consider the different speeds and the different infrastructures we see on the globe. I mean, we are operating on the complete planet, so we have completely different infrastructures in China, South America, Europe. Even in Europe, we have the very old towns with very narrow streets, and we have modern towns with totally different infrastructure. I think there will be an answer for all infrastructures and for all type of cities and streets. So I can imagine we will see very narrow vehicles as well for old cities, and there will be bigger and wider vehicles for modern areas. And still we are traveling, as you said, we are traveling in high speed on the Autobahn, so aerodynamics are still a very, very important factor. So we will see, also in that autonomous future, we will see these different vehicles, the slow urban vehicles and the very fast autonomous driving highway vehicles.
Thank you for your time.
A pleasure.
Thanks.